Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be explaining you Yagi-Uda antenna with great clarity. Before I start with explanation, let me show you how many things that I'm going to cover in this video. See, first of all, I'll be discussing about basics of Yagi-Uda antenna. After that, I'll explain you structure of Yagi-Uda antenna. After that, I'll explain radiation mechanism of Yagi-Uda antenna. After that, I'll explain you designing process of 6 elements Yagi-Uda antenna and designing process of 3 elements Yagi-Uda antenna. At last, I'll be discussing about advantages, disadvantages and applications of Yagi-Uda antenna. So let us begin this video with first agenda, that is basics of Yagi-Uda antenna. Yagi-Uda antenna is also referred as Yagi antenna. Yagi antenna is having directional radiation characteristics. So in directional applications, we use Yagi antenna. If you observe one basic structure of Yagi antenna, then in this, we have three categories of elements. See, here we have director elements, here we have driven element, and here we have reflector element. See, with the use of Yagi-Uda antenna, we can have directional radiation characteristics. Directional radiation characteristics means in certain direction, we will be having higher gain. If I show you radiation pattern, you see it will be appearing somewhat like this, where this is major lobe and here we will be having minor lobes. So in this direction, you'll be observing this Yagi-Uda antenna that is having higher gain. So it is having directional radiation characteristics. We use Yagi antenna in wide range of applications. We can use it for short range communication, for medium range communication, as well as for long range communication. Here in this Yagi antenna, we have two types of elements, active element and parasitic element. See, active element means with that element, we will be applying power supply. In parasitic element, we have again two categories, reflector element and director element. See, these are the director element you can observe. And here we have reflector elements that you can observe, and this is driven element. So here with driven element, we apply power supply, that is active element. And with this reflector element and director element, we don't apply power supply. So those are parasitic element, or you can say passive elements. Now, I'll explain you structure of Yagi-Uda antenna. In a structure of Yagi-Uda antenna, we have three types of elements. Driven element, reflector element, and director elements. If you observe, here we have driven element. See, this driven element, that is active element. The reason is, see, this driven element that is connected with supply. So this driven element, that is active element, the reason is it is connected with supply. This driven element can be dipole antenna or folded dipole antenna in majority of Yagi antennas. You'll be observing with majority of Yagi-Uda antenna, this driven element will be dipole antenna or it may be folded dipole antenna, right? Here you can observe we have reflector element, that is passive element. And it is passive. The reason is here we don't connect power supply with this reflector element, right? So reflector element that is not connected with power supply. That's why it is passive element, or you can say parasitic element. Here, this reflector element that we use it to reflect back lobe of driven element, that I'll show you in radiation mechanism that will give you more clarity. Right now, consider this. See, this reflector element that we use it to reflect power which is coming in backside, right? Here we have director elements that you can observe. These director elements are also passive element, means with director elements, we don't connect any power supply. Passive element can be also referred as parasitic element. See, this director element that is directing major lobe of driven element. That I'll show you in radiation mechanism. So now I'm going to explain you how radiation is happening with Yagi-Uda antenna. To understand radiation mechanism, let us start with radiation by driven element. Here, if you observe, we have driven element. This driven element can be folded dipole or it may be dipole antenna. If you talk about folded dipole or dipole antenna, then it will be having radiation as per this radiation characteristics. You can observe it is having two lobes. This is front direction lobe. I'm saying that as a front lobe, and this is backside radiation. I'm saying that as a back lobe. Now you might be thinking like, why this is back lobe and why this is front lobe? See, in the resultant structure, we are delivered to radiate in this direction. So that's why I'm considering this as a front and this as a back direction. See, with this folded dipole or dipole, if you connect reflector element towards the backside, in that case, this reflector element that will be reflecting power in front direction. So here, because of reflector element, whatever power that is going towards backside, that is getting reflected in front direction. So towards front side, radiation will increase, and towards backside, we will be having minor lobes, right? So now you can observe in front direction, now bit higher power is happening, and in back side, you'll be observing this size of back lobe that is having now minor lobes over here, right? Now after that, if you observe here, we are connecting director elements. See, this director elements that is increasing directivity of Yagi-Uda antenna in this direction. So after connection of this director elements, you'll be observing radiation mechanism that is having sharp beam in this direction. Why it is having sharp beam in this direction? The reason is this director element that is increasing directivity of front lobe. So now you can observe we have increased directivity of front lobe and we will be having small minor lobes over here, right? So this Yagi-Uda antenna that is functioning based on two principles. One is based on reflection and second is based on direction. See, reflection that happens based on impedance mismatch. So here with this reflector element, we provide impedance mismatch. Because of impedance mismatch, whatever power that is coming towards reflector element that is getting reflected in front direction. So here you see with this back lobe, whatever power is happening in this direction, because of impedance mismatch over here, power is getting reflected in front direction. That's why there is a reflection of power in this direction, right? And here directors are doing what? Directors are having impedance matching. Because of impedance matching, whatever power that is going in front direction, that will be having higher directivity. The reason is it will be attracting power towards front direction, right? So here director element that will be having higher impedance matching and reflector element that will be having impedance mismatch, because of which here with this resultant structure of Yagi-Uda antenna that is having directional radiation characteristics, it will be radiating higher power in this direction, right? That is how radiation is happening. Now I'll explain you designing process of this Yagi-Uda antenna. In designing process of Yagi-Uda antenna, first of all, I'll be considering 6-element Yagi antenna. See, in 6-element Yagi antenna, you can observe we have 4 director element, 1 reflector element, and 1 driven element. Driven element is connected with power supply over here. See, this 6-element Yagi-Uda antenna that is having reflector element, which is reflecting power from back side, and that is happening based on impedance mismatch. Size of this reflector element, that is L1, and that has to be 0.475 lambda. Here L2, that is the size of driven element, that will be 0.46 lambda. And here we have director elements that is having size of L3, L4, L5 and L6. L3, L4, L5 that is happening as per 0.44 lambda, 0.44 lambda, 0.43 lambda, and L6 is having size of 0.4 lambda. Here, spacing between reflector and driven element, that is 0.25 lambda. Now, question is why it should be 0.25 lambda? See, always in any design, you will be observing spacing between reflector element and driven element, that will be 0.25 lambda only, right? This spacing, that will be always 0.25 lambda. The reason is, whatever power that is going in backside, that will be getting reflected in front side. So it will be traveled as per 0.25 lambda plus 0.25 lambda. So it will be nullifying phase issues, right? So at last, that signal will be having 0.5 lambda phase when it is coming in front direction, right? So that is getting added with the signal which we are transmitting over here. So in majority of designs, you will be observing spacing between reflector and driven element, that will be 0.25 lambda only. Now see, this X2, X3, X4 and X5, that can be optimized based on whatever functioning that is there with Yagi. Here, with this specific design, X2, X3, X4, that is 0.31 lambda and X5, that is 0.32 lambda, right? But still, I'm saying you, with respect to frequency, you will have to optimize this spacing. Here, I have explained you this design with respect to some specific range of frequencies, right? But with respect to frequency, always some changes will happen and you will have to optimize that spacing, right? Now, I'll explain you one more designing with three elements of Yagi-Uda antenna. Simply, we have three elements only. This is active element, this is director element, and this is reflector element. You see here spacing is 0.25 lambda in between active element and reflector element. Here, director and active element spacing is 0.13 lambda only. And if you observe reflector, it is having length of 0.5 lambda. Active element means driven element, that is having size of 0.44 lambda. And director element, that is having size of 0.43 lambda. By these dimensions, you can easily design three element Yagi-Uda antenna, right? Now, I'll be discussing about advantages, disadvantages and applications of Yagi-Uda antenna. Yagi-Uda antenna is having directional radiation characteristics. Based on that, it offers many advantages. Like you can observe, it is having higher gain. See, more than 9 dB gain can be achieved, and gain is depending on number of elements. So if you increase number of elements, but obviously you will be having higher gain with Yagi-Uda antenna. Here with Yagi-Uda antenna, we have high front to back ratio. The reason is, in backside we have reflector element which is reflecting power from the backside. So here we have higher front to back ratio, and as if you have high front to back ratio, then one can say that is having directional radiation characteristics, right? See, Yagi-Uda antenna, that is cost effective and it is lightweight antenna. If you talk about disadvantages, then you can say with higher gain, you need to have many elements because of which antenna is getting long, and here gain is limited up to 20 dB only. So these are the disadvantages. And as if you talk about applications, there are many applications. Very popular application that you all know, that is based on TV signal reception, right? So TV signal reception, that can be done with the use of Yagi-Uda antenna. For radio broadcasting, we can use it. For amateur radio and for point-to-point communication, we can use it. See, with Yagi, we have many applications. We can use it for short distance communication, medium distance communication, and long distance communication. Short means one should know. Short means up to 100 meter. Medium means up to 20-40 kilometer, and long means it is there in terms of thousands of kilometer, right? When you talk in communication language, at that time you should be clear about what is the meaning of short, medium and long. I hope you have understood this. Still, if anything that you would like to share, just note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.